Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1898. Numbers are not adding up in the status bar.
Mr. Excel's got bills like you. Here's the product placement you gotta sit through.
Hey, just a quick note. So it's July 22nd, 2014. If you happen to be watching this today or tomorrow, two offers expiring soon. I showed Fast Excel V3 a few weeks ago. Charles Williams is offering 50% off. You can save $94 through the end of the month, tinyurl.com/fastexcel. Also, Minda Tracy, our newest Excel MVP, has that amazing Excel dashboard course that she offered last year. Enrollment is again open this year. But the 20% offer is only until July 24th, I think like at 8 p.m. Eastern. So jump in there, tinyurl.com/excel-. All right, this is a bizarre problem. Someone wrote in and said, hey, I have a column of numbers and they are not totaling up down in the status bar. So I selected the numbers here, right? And sure enough, they're totaling. What's the problem? I don't see a problem at all. But then you start to look. Really small number, 1.5, 2.9. Hey, it definitely has to be more than 1.709. So, you know, I'm just kind of cruising around here. They add up. But right here, somehow with that 2.993, we're not getting additions anymore. So, you know, hey, this is simple. Just select the data, text to columns, and finish, and nothing changes. That is my go-to trick. I do that all the time. Converts numbers stored as text to numbers. But there's something wrong here. So let's do equal this number plus zero, right? And that one works. But again, that 2.993 stops working. What the heck is up with this? So then I said, all right, let's do equal trim. Get rid of the leading and trailing spaces, plus zero. Right, and again, it works with the numbers, no problem, and stops working there. Oh my gosh, what is going on? So here's what I did. I said we're going to do equal LEN, the length of that number. And sure enough, for some reason, even though it's 2.993, I'm getting 11. All right, so let's figure out what is happening. Put in the number 1, hold down the control key while I drag the fill handle to get over to 11, and equal mid of that number, press F4 to lock it down, comma, that position, comma 1. Let's break this out. And so we get something invisible there, and then eventually we start getting the 2.993. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4 cells of something invisible, and then 1, 2 cells of something else invisible. Let's see what the invisible thing is with equal code of that invisible thing. Oh my gosh, there we are. It is a character 160, which is and they're all 160s except for a 32 at the end. Okay, so character 160, let's traditionally, character 32 is a regular space, and trim gets rid of regular spaces. Data, text to columns, finish gets rid of regular spaces if they're at the end or the beginning. But this 160 is a non-breaking space, character non-breaking space, and I can almost predict that this number had to come from the web, because on the web, in HTML, we'll code up ampersand NBSP for a non-breaking space in order to fit, in order to force spaces to show up. Usually in HTML, if you type space through space, it becomes just space. But if you need 3 non-breaking spaces to show up, you would type that code 3 times. And that evidently is what's happened. Now, it's really hard to get rid of a non-breaking space because you can't type character 160 into the find and replace box. At least I don't know how to. I'm sure someone will leave a note in the YouTube comments that tells me what the secret keystroke is to do that. But my method is to go to equal char 160, right, which puts that invisible non-breaking space there. We just have to trust that it's there. On the Home tab, I'm going to do copy and then paste as values. All right, so now I have that non-breaking space there. I'm going to go into edit mode, and sure enough, there is a character there that we can't see. I'm going to use shift left arrow to select that invisible character. I'm going to control C to put that on the clipboard. Come back here to our numbers that have problems. Control H for find and replace. Find what? I'm going to do control V. See, I actually pasted the invisible thing in there. And replace with nothing. Do replace all. All done. We made 28 replacements. And let's see here. I bet that actually solved our problem. So there, I selected the numbers, and 11.094. We are good to go. What a bizarre problem, because they look like numbers. There's no little green warning tag there that, hey, this is a number stored as text. That character 160, which is a modern day plague because of people using it in HTML, Excel certainly does not treat that well. The clean function, if any of you are out there shouting clean, use clean, clean does not get rid of 160. It's about time that we update the clean function to handle character 160, and maybe even the trim function to handle character 160, because it is so prevalent. I'm really glad that this person noticed that it wasn't adding up. You know, there's a good chance if you had a few of those scattered in with other numbers that were right, it would have just, no one would have been able to tell. What a horrible problem.
Tips and tricks.
All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast. Mr. Excel.